Friends, so today I'll tell you how to use EDF Playground, how to create account and how to use it for coding purpose. So once you type EDF Playground in the search bar, so the first option will come, EDF Playground edit code. So here you can code with VSDL or Verilog, System Verilog, or you can go for UVM and System Verilog for hardware design, anything you want. So it is a free available tool in the internet and you can access it for coding, for Verilog coding, System Verilog coding or VSDL. So first click here. Then this type window will occur. So the first thing we can do is, first we will go to the login here. Once we go to the login, so for some non-commercial simulators we can either login with Google or Facebook, and if you want to use some commercial simulator, you need to login or register for a full account. And for that full account, just click here, and then we have to give here our company or institution email ID. So if we have email ID of like Gmail, Yahoo or some free available email ID, it won't work. We need some professional company email IDs. So we will just give the all the fill this form and then validate our account. Else we can normally we can go with login with Google Gmail account or with the Facebook. So just click here and just use any of your Gmail ID and validate it, and once you validate you can start coding in Playground. So here we can choose System Verilog. So from here, System plus Design. So from here we can either use System Verilog or VSDL or C++, Perl or whatever we want. So the test bench part is this and the design part is this. So here we will write our design code. So for example, I'll take AND gate design. So just a simple gate design. So here in write the code main module for the AND gate, and left side we'll write the test bench. So there's the test bench we can write here. So I'll just make it more clear. Yeah. So here I have initiates the value, three values, like first is a equal to 0, b equals to 0, as you can see. And another thing, once we save this, so it will mention that T select a validate tool or simulator. So just from here, left side, we'll to this place and then tools. So simply we can choose any tool. So the Synopsys VCS tool, it will work better. And to get the waveform, we have to give these two values here. Just in the code we have to write these two lines, and then we have to enable EP wave after run. Just save it. Yeah, once you will save. Yeah, now we can run it. Yeah, here's the wave window, and as you can see, at 0 we have a equal to 0, b equals 0, then c equals to 0. At 10 nanosecond, a equal to 1, b equal to 1, c equal to 1, and then the last we have, when a equals to 0, b equals a equal to 1, b equals to 0, c 0. So like this we can use this EDF Playground. This is a free available tool available, so we can use it for coding purpose. Thank you. In the next session we will see more about how to use EDF Playground and Xilinx.